Welcome to the XB3 Bluetooth Low Energy session. I will show how to enable, configure and use the Bluetooth Low Energy support on the XB3 RF module, which allows developers to connect the XB module with mobile applications as well as Bluetooth sensors or utilize Bluetooth features such as advertising and beaconing. I will show an example that shows how to retrieve data from a temperature sensor connected directly to the XB module using a Bluetooth connection to a smartphone where the data is visualized in a graphical app. I will also quickly show two samples demonstrating Bluetooth advertising and beaconing. If you haven't done so, I would recommend to watch two other videos before you go ahead with this video, because those videos contain information that I'm reusing in this session. The first video is the Digi XB MicroPython PyCharm IDE plugin demo video. And the second video that I would recommend to watch before this one is the Digi Android Studio extensions demo video. For this demo, I'm using an XB3 module running Zigbee firmware, mounted on an XBIP-C development board from Digi. This development board includes a temperature and humidity sensor, and that allows the IoT demos to be created easily and quickly. To get started, search for the XB Zigbee Meshkit user guide and work through the chapter Get Started with XB Zigbee. This includes the installation of the XCTU tool and the setup of two modules, one as Zigbee coordinator and another one as a Zigbee router. We are going to use the Zigbee router module in our demo. By default, the Bluetooth support is not enabled, so the first step is to enable and configure the Bluetooth parameters on this XB module. And just remember, as usual, also this is explained in great detail in the XB3 Zigbee RF module documentation in the chapter Get Started with BLE. So, if you haven't done so, launch XCTU. Make sure you are in the configuration working mode by using this tab here on the top right corner. Select the module that you want to work with, and then we are going to enable and configure the Bluetooth parameters. Just go here in the search field where you can search for individual parameters if you can't find them in the list, and type in BT, which will highlight the Bluetooth enable parameter. We are going to switch that to 1, enabled. And we are also going to change the Bluetooth identifier. This identifier is used for the beaconing, for example. So we are removing the space, which is the default Bluetooth identifier, and adding something meaningful like XB3 demo. So we are going to recognize that. As you can see, I changed two parameters, which is indicated by these green triangles. So I need to save them into Flash. And since I changed two parameters, it's easy to use this main right button here in the top menu. So I'm going to click that. And this is writing the parameters. If you enable Bluetooth for the first time and the password is not been set yet, then this dialog will come up and it will ask you to configure the password settings. Digi has implemented an additional security layer on top of the normal Bluetooth connectivity, which makes the Bluetooth pairing and connection much safer than the default Bluetooth mechanism. So we are going to configure the password, and you can go into much detail here by enabling advanced configuration and specifying salt and verifier on your own. But we can also let the tool do this. So we are just adding a password. In my case, I will just use 1234 in this case, but obviously you may want to use a little bit stronger password. And you see that the program automatically is adjusting the salt and verifier based on the password that I'm using. When I'm done, I click OK. And also the authentication settings are written into the Flash of the XB module. The easiest way to test Bluetooth connectivity is by using the Digi XB mobile app. This is an app that Digi has developed to demonstrate the use case of connecting to an XB module for configuration purposes. The app can be downloaded in the Google Play Store or the Apple App Store. And again, this is documented in the user manual under Get Started with BLE. There's the subchapter Connect with BLE and Configure your XB3 device, which explains this. After you have downloaded this tool, this app to your smartphone, and you see the screen of my smartphone here on the screen, you can start the app, Digi XB Mobile, and it will scan the Bluetooth interface of the smartphone for devices in the area. And as you can see, it finds already the XB3 demo, and here we can see the Bluetooth identifier that we configured earlier. So I'm going to click on that, and it will ask me to enter the password. And this is the password we have set in the Bluetooth configuration settings earlier. So in my case, this is 1, 2, 3, 4. And if I touch or click OK, it will connect to this module. As you can see, the app shows basic information about this module, this XB module, and also lists a lot of categories with different parameters. For example, we can go into networking, which will show the basic networking parameters of this XB module, the device role, extended PAN ID, the node identifier, which is the Zigbee node identifier in this case, and so on. If we go back, we can also go to the Bluetooth options here, and you can see this contains the settings that we have set earlier, Bluetooth enable, the Bluetooth identifier, and so on. You can set any parameters from this app. Just to give you one example, we can go into networking, go to node identifier, click on that, and you see it opens up the keyboard. So let me change this. I will just remove here the last word in the node identifier, click OK, and then click the write button. This will write the parameter, again over Bluetooth, on the XB module. And similar as with the triangles in XCTU, you can see by the color of the parameter, in this case blue, which parameters have been set by the user and saved into Flash. If I go back to XCTU and refresh the parameters, clicking the read icon, it will show the changed node identifier. As before, I can search for the parameter by using the search field typing NI. And you see the word white has been removed, and I can see that also here in the parameters in XCTU. In this demo, we have shown that the basic Bluetooth communication works by using the Digi XB mobile app. Developers who want to create their own mobile apps utilizing the Bluetooth communication to an XB module can use the Digi XB mobile SDK. This is provided by Digi and includes documentation and a bunch of examples. In the next demo, we will cover a more general use case, which is data communication. And in this demo, we will use one of the examples from the Digi XB mobile SDK to visualize sensor data on the mobile device. The sensor data is coming from the temperature and humidity sensor, which is integrated on the XB development board. To make this work, we need additional MicroPython code on the XB module that will retrieve the sensor values and push them to the Bluetooth interface whenever needed. We can take the required MicroPython code from a sample that is included in the Digi PyCharm IDE plugin for MicroPython. So as you can see, Digi provides all the puzzle pieces to create IoT applications. This is very powerful and highlights the value of the Digi XB ecosystem. Let's start the MicroPython code first using PyCharm. If you have seen the PyCharm IDE plugin video, you know how this works. Let me quickly show you the sample that I'm using. So you can reproduce that. I am using the relay frames temperature sample. If I start this on the XB module, I'm using an XB3 ZigBee module. You can see there's not a lot going on yet, but this code is needed to interface between the I2C sensor and the Bluetooth interface in the XB module. Let's have a quick look at the code. The temperature and humidity values are fetched from the I2C sensors using the I2C library in MicroPython. They are then transformed and then sent to the Bluetooth interface using a command relay.send. This is documented in the DigiMicroPython programming guide. There's a chapter DigiBLE module, which explains the default and standard Bluetooth behavior. And then there's a chapter send and receive user data relay frames. The user data relay functionality is a system added by Digi that allows MicroPython code to connect to other interfaces such as serial or Bluetooth. To find the appropriate code for the mobile device, I am consulting the Digi XB Mobile SDK user guide. And in my case, I'm using an Android device, so I will look for information how to create an application on an Android device, and you can see it's documented here. And according to the documentation, the functionality to create a mobile app on an Android device is implemented in the XB library for Android. So if I click on this link, it opens up the XB Java library documentation. And in here, I can find information how to create an XB Android application. If you follow these instructions using Android Studio, and if you have seen the Android Studio extensions video, you know how this works, you will get a bunch of examples. And the one that you should use for this demo is the BLE MicroPython sample. In this case, I'm running the sample on my own smartphone. So let me quickly show you that. If it's installed, it will create an icon XBBLE MicroPython sample like this, and I can open the application. And similar as the Digi sample app for the management, it will also list the devices which are in the vicinity, which have Bluetooth enabled. So I'm connecting to the XB3 demo. Again, I have to enter the Bluetooth password, as we have said before. I'm connecting to the device. And if everything works, I can click Start here, and it will display the temperature and the humidity values. It will update every 5 seconds. That's where the text flashes green. To conclude this session, I would quickly show you two further examples. Both are MicroPython implementation in the XB module, and both implement additional Bluetooth functionality. The first sample is the Gap Advertise sample, which you can find here, Bluetooth Gap Advertise, which shows the default Gap Advertisement feature from Bluetooth Low Energy. In the sample, you can define your own advertisement name. And if you run that and you use a mobile device using any kind of Bluetooth scanner, you will be able to scan for this advertisement. As you can see, this contains information like signal strength and ping time. So this could be used for very basic localization applications. The second sample I want to show is a bit more advanced. It is the Bluetooth Eddystone Advertise sample. And this is using the Google Eddystone Beaconing library and protocol. As you can see in the code of this sample, you can add a lot more information to these beacons, which make them probably more useful for localization or other types of services. And if you run this sample on the XB module, this MicroPython sample, you need an app on your smartphone that is able to scan and read those Eddystone beacons. I am using an app called Beacon Scanner from the Google Play Store. And if I start scanning, I should be able to see the beacons that are generated by my XB device. Here we go. You see it's transmitting an Eddystone UID and an Eddystone URL. As you can see, there's a lot more information provided, including the approximate distance from the smartphone to the module, which is really nice and surprisingly works quite well. If I move my smartphone closer to the module, you can see the distance decreasing. And that concludes this demo video. Thank you very much for your attention.